Hello and welcome to RLRX Network. I'm your friend and this amazing video, which is the 13th video of this VBA series. In this video, I will teach you what is strings in VBA and how we can use strings in VBA. So strings like a variable. For example, a variable can store only numbers, but and strings can store number, text, values, etc. So how we can use the strings in VBA, let's go to our VBA page and do the coding for VBA. So for this, what will I do? I will just click on developer tab and will click on Visual Basics to open Visual Basics page. Alright, and here we will start coding for strings. So I will just give subject name, which would be strings value. Any subject name you can give. I'm just typing strings value, and first of all I will give the comments. So a string can store text, comma, numbers, comma, etc. Anything that can store string which name as strings. Alright. So here I will declare three dim for strings. So first will I take dim str, the string name which I am giving str1 as string. Alright. And then I will declare str2 for string 2 as string, and then I will declare str3 as string. Alright, so here I have declared three strings. So let's describe the string work. So for first str1 will I only put a message that would be a string can store number. Any message you can just put it. Alright, then for string 2 means str2 I will give, let's say I'm just giving any number you can give, I'm just typing 7. Alright, and for the str3 I will use str1 ampersand str2 multiply str2. Alright, I will teach you in next words what is the use of these strings, and here the result will be declared in which cell. So for this I will type this workbook dot sheets, then in which sheet. So let's get back to our work Excel sheet, and here the sheet name is sheet 1. So we will declare here sheet 1, course close, then we are going to type this message in cells. So I will type cells, and in this time I will declare the A1 cell to define this code. So here I will take 1, 1, it means that is A1 cell. First row, first column means A1 cell, then close the bracket, and then we'll press is equal to an str3. Alright, so what is the meaning of this code? Here I have taken three strings. In first string I have just defined a simple line which is a string can store a number. In str2 I will just define a number which is 7, but in str3 when this code will go back to sheet 1 and A1 cells, then what will happen, it will display a message a string can store number, and str2 number means 7 into 7, it means the total message will be appear a string can store number 49, because 7 into 7 is equal to 49. Alright, so let's run the code and see the result. So get back to our worksheet, and here you can see this is done, a string can store number. Also you can use Alt F8 key to run this macro and just run it. Here you can see, because 7 into 7 is equal to 49. Let's change the value. Let's say I'm taking here 13, and when I will run this code, then what will happen, let's see, 13 into 13 is equal to 169. So this is how you can just use basic concept of strings, and you can just put a number and text together. Alright, so in this video we have just learned what is string and what is the use of basic strings. In next video I will use strings with input box and message box. Alright, so till then, if you like this video, please like it. If you did not subscribe my channel still, please subscribe it. And if you have any query regarding this video, so you can just put the comments below of this video and I will meet you in next video to resolve your query and to make you an VBA expert and Excel expert. Alright, so we'll meet you next video. Till then, goodbye.